The stock market is a forward-looking animal, and so oftentimes it will start to price in the economic recovery before we see that recovery. But this is also baking in expectations about how monetary policy and fiscal intervention will be digested. And that's a really big part of the thesis that the stock market is baking in right now. When it comes to actual reflation, as you said, it will start to matter more about whether all the money that's being put into the market is actually getting spent and by whom. So then you also have to ask questions about divergence potentially between the path of consumer spending and business investment as well.
What do you make of European stocks? I mean, whichever of the three major indices you look at in the U.S., they've all comfortably outperformed, certainly the Nasdaq, but all three, most of the European indices. Is there value there?
Our outlook is currently stronger for the U.S. Than it is for Europe. And some of that, you know, we've already seen in the trends. It's encouraging that Europe has come together on the policy standpoint to try to work as a union, truly, in an organized way towards a recovery. But right now, we're still waiting to see some of the effects of that come through in the numbers and in the data. And it's in our outlook not currently being reflected as well as it is for the U.S. You know, let's wait and see. One thing that's really encouraging to me when I look at the Europeans' perspective on the recovery is the way that they've embedded broader social environmental goals and their intention to build back better. You know, really thinking about how to advance the climate agenda, how to advance certain social priorities in the way that they're reinvesting. And, you know, I've got to think that for the long term, that that's going to give Europe an edge. And I hope that we'll be able to have deeper conversations about those types of topics as we plan our recovery here in the States as well.